Hey yo, what's up everyone? This is Chris from Chris Aquatics and today I'm gonna be showing you guys the step by step and the result of the breeding project that I have done with this white polar cichlids. As you can see, I have here my fully grown breeder sizes white polar platinum parrot cichlids. So this is also known as convict cichlids because for some reasons. Okay, so I have bought it from when they were so young, and then now that they are breeders, I decided to breed them. So let's go. For this breeding project, I have bought 3 pieces of 5-gallon tank from a aquatic store. So this is a very cheap because I bought it directly from the one who manufacture aquariums. So okay, so this 5-gallon tank is divided into two. So I used a glass divider and a suction cup to hold this glass divider. So in total of 6 pieces of 2.5 tank. So okay, each of it has a clay pot. So I also bought a clay pot from a poultry supply, and I divided it into two. So using a hacksaw, actually an iron saw. Okay guys, so I cut this clay pot using a saw so that it will be pleasing in the eyes because it's just perfect, as you can see. So I also bought a pebbles. This is a medium sized pebbles from the aquatic store. So these pebbles will provide the beneficial bacteria for the tanks. So it is very important, and it is very crucial for me to put some pebbles on these tanks because beneficial bacteria are very, very, very important for our fishes, especially for our breeders, because yeah, breeding time is a very important important part of this hobby. So we don't want to fail, so we want the best for these breeders. Also guys, each tank has a sponge filter, and this is just a very small sponge filter for the bioloads or the beneficial bacteria to thrive.
A few moments later.
Okay, so while I am waiting for the initial setup for the cycle of this tank, so I will be going to cycle this tank for a week. So many of you will ask me why should I cycle my tank. So the purpose of cycling your tank guys is so that the water parameters will be on level, I mean will be stable, no nitrate, no ammonia, I guess, no ammonia spike or whatever. So the water parameters will be good for your breeders so that it could not harm your fish, because as you all know, our tap water has a chlorine on it, and that chlorine is very harmful for our fishes. So we need to cycle the tank. So some of you will ask me why 1 week. 1 week because I already put some stock water on it from my 35-gallon tank. I do it so that it will be less in the time of the cycle.
1 week later.
So after 1 week later, I put all the pairs of the white polar cichlids here on the breeding tank. So as you can see, the water is so clear. We just have a bit of algae because of the light, but it is looking good. So as you can see, I also put some plants on each of the tanks. Plants are very important to avoid any ammonia spike. They also they're also the ones who level the water parameters. They keep the water clean, and they also provide oxygen for our fishes. So plants had a very, very important role when it comes to fish keeping, especially when it comes to breeding. So as you can see, I put some plants, I put some lights, and all these breeders are happy. Although some of these breeders are not yet proven breeders, So you still need to watch over them and time to time, so you can see if some of them will be aggressive, because when it comes to aggressions, inbreeding, it may cause harm to the other fishes, and eventually it could kill one of them.
A few moments later.
Okay guys, after a while, I think this is a day or two, one of my breeders, or some of the pairs of breeders here, are already laid their eggs inside the clay pots. So that's the purpose of the clay pots. The clay pots make them feel secured when they lay their eggs, even though these pairs see each other, and it may cause stress to them. So I suggest to you guys that if you do this kind of breeding, you should put a divider that you should not put a transparent divider between the pairs, so that as much as possible they should not see each other.
1 week later.
Okay, after 1 week, as you can see, the pebbles or the substrate are already scattered. So one behavior of these white polar cichlids, when it comes to breeding, they are preparing their place. So they make a burrow within the substrate. So I call it as a nest. So that in that way they could secure their fry or their eggs from any predators or any other adult cichlids that can eat their fry. So as you can see, all of them has hatched their eggs. So all of these pairs are already proven pairs. So we can now conclude that these pairs are already proven, because they already laid eggs, and these eggs are already hatched and fertile. So what we're going to do now is to wait until this fry, or newly hatched fry, is free swim.
1 week later.
Okay guys, so about another week or two, the newly hatched fries are already free swimming. So when you see that these fries are already free swim, it is an indication that you can now remove or separate the parents from them. But if you don't want to separate them, you can just let them stay with their parents, as long as you can see that the parents are take a good care for their fry. Because there are also some instances that these white polar cichlids are very aggressive, and if they are stressed within a community tank where they lay their eggs and they produce their fry, there is a very big chance that these parents will eat their fry. So it is important that you monitor time to time your white polar cichlids. But if you see that the parents are taking good care of their fry, and that is an indication that you can let the fry grow up together with their parents. So I already tried it, and I already tested it. Fries are, this baby fish will grow rapidly if they are with their parents. Okay, so I suggest you to let them grow with their parents, as long that their parents are gentle and they will not get eaten by their parents.
Many months later.
Okay guys, I am happy to tell you, for about a month and 2 weeks, I guess, this is the result of our breeding project. So as you can see, we already have a lot of baby white polar cichlids. Actually, these fishes that you are seeing right now are just produced by two pairs. So I already put some of the fry of these juvenile white polar cichlids outside on my backyard setup, because as they grow, these 5-gallon setups will be very small for them, and it may cause any hindrances for their growth. So I decided to separate them so that this fry will grow faster or rapidly. So as you can see, I already, for the first month of this fry, I feed them only live foods, or as much as possible, at least a decapsulated baby brine shrimp. So there is no need for you to hatch a brine shrimp. So if you don't have time to hatch it, you can buy a decapsulated. Decapsulated means it already hatched, it is dried. So I prepared this using a water, and I dissolve it on a water, and then I give it to them directly. As you can see, they enjoy eating it. Alright guys, so that's it for now. I hope you like this video. If you like this video, and if you want many videos to come, many videos like this to come, please don't forget to like and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Sorry for my bad English, but I'm doing my best to speak in this language so that all of my viewers could understand everything that I am doing with my hobby. So it's either they are Filipinos, it's either they are Americans, or whatever part of the world. Okay, so thanks for watching this video. I hope this video gives you a good vibes and inspires you to do your own breeding project. So this is Chris Aquatics, and again, good vibes everyone. Peace out and God bless you all.